हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू सीनियर टू जूनियर एकेडमी। सो वील कंटिन्यू आवर सीरीज ऑन टॉप कोर कंपनीज इंटरव्यू क्वेश्चन विथ एक्सप्लेनेशन, एंड दिस इज़ द 19th क्वेश्चन ऑन दैट पर्टिकुलर सीरीज। फॉर ऑल आवर न्यू व्यूअर्स, दोज हु हैव नॉट वॉच्ड ऑल आवर प्रीवियस वीडियो, आई विल रिक्वेस्ट देम टू प्लीज़ वॉच ऑल आवर 18 वीडियोज बिफोर वॉचिंग दिस क्वेश्चन। इट विल हेल्प यू अ लॉट, एंड वील सी आवर नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इन दिस सीरीज। सो होप यू लाइक दिस। सो द क्वेश्चन इन दिस सीरीज will be that is asked in many of your companies is why in tractor rear tires are big while front tires are small. So you might have seen many tractors in your life. Have you wondered why rear tires are big while front tires are small? So before going to analyze this question, just like to give you some important information. Like in automobile you have three kind of configuration. First one is your front wheel drive, second one is your rear wheel drive, and third one is your all wheel drive. Front wheel drive are the configuration in which your front wheel gets the power from the engine and your back wheels are free to rotate. Example can be all your Maruti cars. And rear wheel drive is the case when your back wheels get the power from the engine and your front wheels are free to rotate. This tractor is an example of rear wheel drive. All your Mahindra car can be an example of rear wheel drive. Third configuration is your all wheel drive, which is a case when all your four wheels are getting drive from the engine. Your modern tractors are coming with such kind of technology. So a bit about tractor can be like, tractors are normally used for rough terrains and plowing fields. You know, these are the off-road vehicles. The terrain may be filled with muds and provide imbalanced drive. So in order to tackle such kind of problem, you need this kind of configuration. So let's move to our main question, why the rear wheels are big and front wheels are small. So here I have put 2 to 3 reasons why rear wheels are big. So first one is your traction. You know that from traction only the word tractor had come, T-R-A-C-T-O-R. Traction has helped to develop a word tractor. So traction has got an important role to play in these kind of concepts. So how can a traction be responsible for having a big wheel? So let us explain. You know that tractors are generally employed for plowing purpose and wet field, muddy areas. So let us draw a side view of that big rear wheels. You can see this is the side view. As you can see, the surface area of this tire touching the ground is more. You know the relation, pressure is equals to force upon area. What happens if area is increased, your pressure will decrease. So pressure is decreased means the weight of the tractor putting on the ground will decrease and it will not get stuck in the wet or muddy fields. So this is the most important reason of having a big rear wheels. You will get enough traction to come out of the muddy field and your tire will not get stuck to the muddy fields. So this is one of the reason of having a big wheel on back. The second one is your pulling purpose. You know that tractors are generally employed for having a high strength heavy duty purpose, and they are generally for use for plowing or used for as to pull a carrier on its back. So in order to understand this concept, I need to tell you that while dealing with engine, we generally use two terms, that is speed and one is your torque. And means you have to compromise between these two terms, like speed and torque. Whenever you want high speed, your torque has to be low, or if you want low speed, your torque has to be high. But in tractor, you know that it's a low speed application vehicle. It's generally used for plowing field or off-road purpose, so its speed doesn't matter in case of tractor, but your torque matters. So let me explain this by putting one small example. If you have seen a small motor of your fan that is small and it has a high RPM, speed is more, but it can generate a very low amount of torque. On the other hand, if you put a giant gear to it, what will happen? This giant gear will have a low speed, low RPM, but torque generated due to this will be high. So generally your tractors are used for high torque application purpose. So torque matters in case of tractor, not the speed. So this is the reason why your big rear wheels are big, because it will generate more torque as it has more radius, and more torque will be generated, so it can pull a heavy duty high strength, and it will do more strengthable jobs for you. And third one is your obstacle. Obstacle is generally means, according to me, this term is basically a combination of traction and pulling force. Generally, you know that tractor is employed in off-road vehicles where terrains are not uniform. So if you are having a small wheel on its back, there are chances that it may get stuck somewhere in the ground. So it will be impossible to pull out. But if your rear wheels are big, no matter how the obstacle is, it may be able to get out of the obstacle, and you can ride and drive your tractor safely. So this is one of the reasons. This is not an important reason, but these two are the important reason. Now coming back to front small wheels. Front small wheel has a no logical concept. It's just to have a flexible steering for you. If wheels are small in the front, a driver will have a flexible steering system in his hand, and he will ride a better and comfortable journey to his tractor. So this is, I have written that only purpose of having a small wheel in front is to have better steering. We do not need a bigger wheel for steering. If wheels are bigger, then steering might get difficulty, and also it will be very difficult for steering if the wheels are big. So only reason is that you are having a better steering if your wheels are small in the front. So I hope I have made a clear concept regarding why the rear wheels are big. The most important terms for this will be traction and pulling forces. So I hope I have made a clear concept on this. So if you have got any queries on this, please mail us at s2gacademy@gmail.com, and if you want the slide for this PPT I can provide, please mail us at that. You can join our group where over 550 members are present, and you can obviously like our page, and please subscribe to the channel so that you get a regular update when we upload a next interesting question for you. So I thank you all for watching. Share knowledge, share success. All the best.